Hematocrit refers to the percentage of your blood that consists of red blood cells. It's often used as a measure of the overall health and oxygen carrying capacity of the blood. Higher hematocrit levels indicate more red blood cells, while lower levels may be a sign of anemia or other health issues. As I'm sure you know, keeping a balanced hematocrit level is crucial for overall health, but it can sometimes fall below the normal range, which is why this video will explore the most effective methods to increase hematocrit levels, focusing on areas such as dietary changes, lifestyle modifications, and medical interventions. Keep watching until the end, because there's one technique that most people aren't aware of. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. The first way to increase hematocrit levels involves iron supplementation. Iron is a critical element in the production of hemoglobin, a protein in red blood cells that enables them to carry oxygen. If your body doesn't have enough iron, it can lead to a decrease in the number of red blood cells and, subsequently, a lower hematocrit level. Taking iron supplements can help increase the iron levels in your body, thereby supporting the production of more red blood cells and increasing your hematocrit. Number 2. Erythropoiesis-Stimulating Agents. These are medications that encourage your body to produce more red blood cells. They work by mimicking the action of a natural hormone called erythropoietin, which is produced by the kidneys and stimulates the bone marrow to produce more red blood cells. They can be prescribed by a doctor in certain cases, such as chronic kidney disease or chemotherapy-induced anemia, to increase the hematocrit level. Number 3. Eat a high iron diet. Just like iron supplementation, incorporating iron-rich foods into your diet can also help boost your body's production of red blood cells. Foods such as red meats, beans, dark leafy greens, and fortified cereals are high in iron. By ensuring that your diet contains sufficient iron, you can help your body naturally increase its hematocrit levels. Combining iron-rich foods with those high in vitamin C can further boost iron absorption. Number 4. Take vitamin B12 and folate supplements. Both vitamin B12 and folate, aka vitamin B9, play a crucial role in red blood cell production. A deficiency in either can lead to a form of anemia known as megaloblastic anemia, where the body produces fewer, larger red blood cells, leading to a lower hematocrit level. Taking B12 and folate supplements can help prevent this type of anemia and maintain a healthy hematocrit level. Number 5. Get adequate hydration. Dehydration can lead to a higher hematocrit level because it reduces the volume of plasma in the blood, making the proportion of red blood cells seem higher. However, this is a false increase, and the hematocrit level will decrease once you're rehydrated. Staying adequately hydrated helps to maintain the right balance of plasma and red blood cells, thus ensuring an accurate hematocrit level. Number 6. Perform regular exercise. Regular physical exercise stimulates the production of erythropoietin, a hormone that promotes the production of red blood cells. This is because exercising muscles need more oxygen, and the body responds by making more red blood cells to deliver that oxygen. Therefore, maintaining a regular exercise regimen can contribute to a higher hematocrit level. Number 7. Limit your alcohol intake. Chronic and heavy alcohol consumption can interfere with the production and functioning of red blood cells, potentially leading to anemia and a lower hematocrit level. Alcohol can hinder the absorption of vital nutrients like iron and vitamins needed for red blood cell production. Cutting back on alcohol or stopping altogether can improve the body's ability to produce and maintain a healthy amount of red blood cells, thereby potentially increasing hematocrit levels. Number 8. Quit smoking. Smoking can lead to a falsely elevated hematocrit level as it reduces the amount of oxygen in the blood, prompting the body to produce more red blood cells to compensate. However, these extra red blood cells can make the blood thicker and more likely to clot, poisoning health risks. Furthermore, smoking can damage the lungs and reduce their capacity to transfer oxygen to the blood, further stressing the body. Quitting smoking can help restore normal red blood cell production and a true, healthy hematocrit level. Number 9. Get enough sleep. Sleep is when a lot of the body's restorative processes occur, including the production of new cells. Inadequate sleep can disrupt these processes, potentially impacting the body's ability to produce an optimal amount of red blood cells and maintain a healthy hematocrit level. Ensuring you get enough quality sleep can help support overall health and the efficient production of red blood cells. Number 10. Eat a healthy diet. Certain foods are particularly rich in nutrients that are important for red blood cell production and can help increase your hematocrit level. This includes iron-rich foods such as red meat, poultry, fish, lentils, beans, and fortified cereals. Folate-rich foods such as dark leafy greens, asparagus, Brussels sprouts, avocados, and legumes. Vitamin B12-rich foods such as fish, meat, poultry, eggs, and milk. Vitamin C-rich foods including oranges, strawberries, bell peppers, and broccoli. Copper-rich foods such as shellfish, whole grains, nuts, and seeds. And vitamin A-rich foods such as carrots, sweet potatoes, spinach, and kale. Number 11. Use pharmacological agents. Which is just a fancy way of saying to take advantage of certain medications. Several types of drugs may be used to increase hematocrit levels, particularly in individuals with conditions that reduce the production or lifespan of red blood cells. As with any medication, these drugs should only be used under the guidance of a healthcare professional. Some examples include erythropoiesis-stimulating agents, iron supplements, vitamin B12 and folate supplements, testosterone, corticosteroids, and hydroxyurea. But remember, while these medications can increase hematocrit, they can also have side effects and risks, and their use should be monitored by a healthcare professional. Number 12. Use medical treatments. Medical interventions to increase hematocrit generally focus on increasing red blood cell production or addressing the underlying causes of a low hematocrit level. Some examples include iron, vitamin B12 or folate injections, blood transfusions, testosterone replacement therapy, bone marrow or stem cell transplants, and treatment of the underlying condition. Keep in mind that these treatments should be administered under the guidance of a healthcare professional and may have side effects and risks that need to be considered. But, as you can see, increasing hematocrit levels is a multifaceted approach that requires adherence to a balanced lifestyle and, if needed, medical intervention. It's important to remember that while these strategies can help enhance hematocrit levels, they're not substitutes for professional medical advice. Changes in hematocrit levels can be symptoms of underlying conditions that require medical attention. If you suspect that your hematocrit levels are low, consult with a healthcare professional who can provide personalized advice and treatment based on your individual circumstances. With the right guidance and actions, it is possible to achieve and maintain a healthy hematocrit level, contributing to overall vitality and health. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.